really weren't. You were leading them astray. And the common enemy is not us. It's not the media. I mean, listen, maybe it's someone else. It's not me. It's not you. To the best of my ability, I tell you the truth every night, and if I screw it up, I apologize and I correct it. But these people are being lied to and have been lied to for at least the past 5 years. And now we happen to be coming out of an election that was very contentious, and he actually lost, and he's trying to change the reality on that. We're in the middle of a pandemic that he didn't handle well, and he is trying to change the narrative and rewrite history on that. And I don't know how to reach people who, I don't think you're ever going to get the diehards, but the people who are right now saying, okay, yeah, maybe it's time to get on board, because if whether you believe Joe Biden won the election or not, he did, at this point, he's going to be your leader. He's your only hope. Donald Trump is not your hope. He's going to be gone from Pennsylvania Avenue.
There's a different play going on, assuming that that's right. And by the way, you know, I hope that is right. Trump is out. He lost. He should be gone. If there's any other outcome other than
he's
that,
he's not out yet.
It will be chaos.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? Even that is living a lie. Transition has always been a real thing. Lame duck exists as a term for the last year in this period for a reason.
I completely agree with you.
So they're playing by the letter of a law that they don't even want to follow.
Yeah.
But that's where my darkness comes in, which is my theory is we are knitted together by the rules. That's our national religion, the rules, the faith in justice and the pursuit of justice, right? They said pursuit of justice for a reason. Why? Hard to attain, especially in this kind of heterogeneous society, as we've seen painfully time and again. But once you decide, nah, the rules don't work, brother. They don't work equally. They don't work for me. They don't work for people who look like you. So why should they work on this level just because you want them to? Once you reach that breaking point, which is where Trump has taken us, he didn't start the fire. He is the fever of an illness that has been here for a long time. He has people, 9 in 10 of the Republicans in Congress, that's why you call them the Trumplicans, 9 in 10 of these people say the rules don't really apply.
I'm sorry, I blame him. I think you can blame him.
I'm saying it goes beyond him.
It does, but he didn't start the fire, but he's certainly throwing in logs every single day.
He's turbocharger.
He's throwing in accelerant every single
day. He is gasoline.
And he is, we cannot forget that he is, I know we're in a transition, as you say, he is still the leader of the free world. And if he wasn't, we would not be paying attention to him the way we do now, because what he says is important, what he does is important, and it has consequence.
Right.
All of it. So,
but his people don't have to be around him like this. That party didn't have to capitulate, literally, the meaning of the word, give their head to this guy.
They didn't
have to do that.
They did, but that's why it irks me so much when people say, well, that not everybody believes in that. Not all of those people
Nine out of ten.
And that is because those people are leading the flock, so to speak, astray. Those people should be leading. They should be setting the precedent for the people of America, and they're not doing that. They are misleading them as well. I got to go. I'm going to continue. We need to talk about this and figure it out, though.
This is all we're going to be talking about for the rest of our lives.
Yeah.
This is the story of our present and our future.
If we don't figure
this out, we will never get to a better place than we are today.
Yeah. See you soon.
But it all starts with this. I love you, D. Lemon.
I love you more. I'll see you soon. Let's continue to talk. Okay, so